Hi everyone, my name is JV and I am a software engineer at Microsoft. Today I'm excited to walk you through an incredibly powerful feature called User Insights. User Insights provides admins and developers with crucial data such as total user count, monthly active users, daily active users, new users, authentications, and multi-factor authentication usage. This data helps make informed decisions about your tenants. This feature is accessible in a Microsoft Entra External ID External Tenant through Microsoft Graph APIs and as a dashboard on the Microsoft Entra Admin Center. In this video, I'll walk you through how to access, interpret, and filter through the various metrics we are making available to you on the Entra Admin Center. For you to have access to these metrics, you will need to be in the admin role within your External ID tenant. To access the blade on the Microsoft Entra Admin Center, you go to Identity, Monitoring and Health, Usage and Insights, and you'll find it under Application User Activity. You can also access via the shorthand aka.ms/External ID User Insights. Once you have Application User Activity loaded up, you will have access to three tabs: Users, Authentications, and Multi-Factor Authentication Usage. Let's step through each of these to see the value proposition you get from all the chats that we provide out of the box on Microsoft Entra. Starting from the Users tab, we will look at the top section. The Users tab is very essential for your user engagement metrics when you want to look at user trends, user behavior, and user retention. This will allow you to make the most informed decisions about your users within your applications based on how they are behaving. Let us start with, at the top, total users. Here you can be able to see a comparison against the previous month and see whether you have growth, whether you have stayed stagnant, or whether there's a decline. Similarly, for monthly active users, new users added, and monthly inactive users, all at the top, you can be able to see percentage growth or decline of the various numbers here. This allows you to see at a quick glance your acquisition and your retention as well. Below this, we get to see new users added activity over time. Here you can be able to look at daily charts and trend lines of activity across your applications. How many folks are active? How many are inactive? You can filter this down into specific time periods and also get to see a bit more. You'll see the average active users and average inactive users for that time period that you have selected. Below this, you also get to see a month-on-month snapshot of previous months' active users and inactive users. To the side of this, you get to see a breakdown of the top applications by activity. You get to see how many users were active within those applications. And you can drill down a bit with your operating system as a dimension. Going to the very bottom, now let's look at user acquisition. We'll be able to see your new users added. Here we provide you with a lot more dimensions to filter through to really understand how your customers are engaging with your applications. You can be able to see a month-on-month comparison, and you can get to filter this even more deeply. To the side of this, you also get to see a bit more of a breakdown against operating system. This allows you to shift your efforts that your business is making and correlate the activity you are doing against things like your marketing campaigns and various initiatives across. Under your authentication tab, you'll have various visualizations that are going to be very essential around looking at your security posture. This will also allow you to really understand your user behavior, why you need to make adjustments to secure applications further, and also how you're utilizing some of the resources you have at your disposal. We will start at the top where we look at monthly requests. This is very essential for your security analysts within your team and IT for admins as well. You can be able to look at the volume of requests your applications are sending through as you're trying to make authentications successfully or attempted across your applications. You can be able to filter this a bit more to really understand where these requests are coming from and the patterns they're in. Below this, you will have your authentications over time, where you can be able to see a daily trend line of how users' authentication into your applications. You can be able to filter this against various dimensions to see even more granular metrics and information around the user behavior. You can break this down by operating system as well, against these various dimensions. And this is very essential when you really want to understand this behavior by users and really need to know what course of action to take. Below this, you also get to see authentication by location. This offers you the geographical distribution of the authentications, allowing you to visualize where the activities are most frequent across your applications, and also understand whether the behaviors you are seeing are what you expect. For instance, you could see spikes in areas where you did not expect to have any user activity, and you could take the necessary course of action against that or be able to inform whatever business decisions you are making. You can also be able to see monthly authentications over time and break this down even further. You can be able to see in terms of behaviors such as successful authentications, failed authentications, and issues that your customers may be facing within your applications. So for instance, you can be able to see a breakdown by users who had incomplete authentication attempts, whether there was configuration errors, whether there were user errors, where there were authentication denied, and also other kinds of issues that your customers may have been experiencing within your applications. This allows you to really change tact, address these issues and bottlenecks, as well as the pain points your customers may be having across your applications. You can make these changes and really optimize the user experience that you're offering to your customers. Having a look at the MFA usage tab, or multi-factor authentication usage, you'll be able to see a lot of insights that can really drive decisions that are going to be made around securing your customers and also securing costs for your business. Let us start at the top by looking at policies that require MFA. You'll be able to see how many of these policies need to be reconfigured to have MFA enabled. You also get to see the distribution of users across the MFA implementations available on your applications. You can get to understand user trends in terms of preference and also get to see the effort required to migrate users over to more preferred MFA methods. Below this, you can also get to see the usage of these MFA types. How often are users applying one MFA type against the other? This allows you to understand user behavior and patterns. Looking to the side of this, we also get to see MFA usage success and failure, where you can see a breakdown of how often the specific failure types and errors appear for your customers, potential bottlenecks that they may be having that you could address, as well as potential instances where bad actors may be trying to compromise your applications. The charts below showcase telecom fraud metrics. This is essential in allowing our security analysts and IT admins to evaluate the effectiveness of various implementations that secure them from telephony fraud by vectors such as international revenue share fraud, which would utilize bots, bulk account creation, and other approaches that malicious actors along the telecom chain may utilize to abuse their resources. Here you can be able to look at the effectiveness of the capture triggers that have been implemented and users who've been challenged by it. So here we can be able to see how many users were successful through those capture events or how many failed. You can also get to see just a comparative pie chart here where these customers were either allowed through or were blocked completely through the capture activity. A large number of users being prompted and blocked by the capture challenges might indicate a potential attack and allow for the team to analyze the effectiveness of the security systems. Similarly, just the spikes in the capture challenges would also allow the teams to investigate and determine whether the user behavior and environments contribute to the failures and identify the friction points to be fixed. By leveraging the User Insights feature, You can make data-driven decisions that enhance user engagement and optimize the performance of your Microsoft Entra External ID tenant. If you have any questions or need further assistance, feel free to reach out to our support team or visit our documentation.